Gene Dodaro is the head of the Government Accountability Office. It oversees federal operations and protects American taxpayer dollars. Gene, welcome to the program.
Hello, Mimi. It's nice to be with you.
So one of your highest profile reports of 2022 was around college financial aid. What did you look at specifically, and what did you find?
Well, given the concern about the debt burden of students, we looked at whether or not colleges and universities were providing accurate information to students and their parents ahead of time so that they could make well-informed decisions about the financial costs of attending these colleges and universities. And what we found in 91% of the colleges that they didn't provide accurate information to the students and parents about what the actual cost would be of attending that university. They understated some costs. For example, they may have left out housing and food costs. They may have not given any cost information at all. So we recommended that the Congress require more standardized information be given to students and parents so that they could make, you know, do some comparison shopping, find out whether or not they can really afford to attend the colleges and universities that they would like to, and make decisions, thereby, I think, helping to help them manage the debt burden that we've seen be a problem for many students and their parents, so that we could help them going forward.
And there were obviously a lot of reports that you did on the CARES Act and pandemic relief funding. What stood out for you on those reports?
Well, we continue to make recommendations both in the public health area as well as in program integrity issues. In the health area, I was very pleased to see that the Transportation Department changed their approach in response to a recommendation we made back in 2015, maybe, that they develop a transportation safety program for communicable diseases. And previously they said it wasn't their responsibility, it should be HHS or DHS. And we said, no, we think you should lead it. It needs to be international in scope. So they changed their approach. So they're beginning to work on it. And then Congress also required them to develop this in the latest Consolidated Appropriations Act for this year. So I was very encouraged by that. The Small Business Administration input procedures to comport with our recommendations for better oversight over the emergency loan programs, PPP and the Economic Injury Disaster Loan Program. And they avoided forgiving loans that they might not have done before. That was about $3.5 billion. So there's, you know, some efforts underway, but there's still a lot of work to do. You know, we designated HHS's leadership and coordination as a high risk area across the federal government out of our normal 2-year cycle with the beginning of each new Congress. We also designated the unemployment insurance area high risk. And of course, we already had designated the SBA emergency loan programs as high risk. So there's a lot of work that needs to be done on program integrity to get our nation better prepared for future public health emergencies. So, you know, some progress, but there's a lot more that needs to be done. And that's why I wanted to focus on the high-risk issues.
I want to ask you about aid sent to Ukraine. Your agency received an additional $7.5 million in new funding to oversee that. What are the major areas that you'll be investigating, and how will you measure impact of that aid during an ongoing war?
Yeah, well, we've looked at such aid in the past, for example, Iraq and Afghanistan and other aid that we provide the country. So we're well prepared to take on these new responsibilities. We'll look at whether or not the agencies that are administering the aid have good plans for internal controls and oversight over the work. You know, we'll do some, you know, independent testing of that information. We're developing an oversight plan now, and we'll be looking at various aspects of how the aid was used, how the departments are measuring the effectiveness of the aid, and whether it's achieving the objectives that were intended by the Congress. And so we've done this before in many countries, and we'll be doing it again in the Ukraine.
And GAO has been informing Congress about science and technology trends. You've done reports on long COVID, artificial intelligence. What are some of the trends you'll be following for this year?
Well, I think artificial intelligence will continue to be a dominant trend, Mimi. There's a lot of attention provided to it in the National Defense Authorization Bill for this year, making sure that there's competition, that we can meet the competition that we have from near-peer competitors, China, for example. Same thing with quantum computing, hypersonic weapons. But we're also focused on in the medical area, regenerative medicine, for example, in that arena. Also in the energy area, we're going to be looking at carbon management, as well as utility scale energy storage areas. And of course, you know, with the advent of electronic vehicles, you know, the use of autonomous vehicles also. And so both from an energy standpoint, from batteries and other matters, as well as the use of autonomous vehicles. So our work really spans a spectrum of the interest that Congress has and the pervasive impact that science and technology has. And it's almost ubiquitous across the entire federal government's operations. That's why we've tripled the number of people we have in that area over the last couple of years.
All right. Well, Gene, thanks so much for joining us. Nice to talk to you.
Always great to be with you, Mimi. Take care and Happy New Year.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any future Government Matters interviews.